In previous videos on this channel, we've talked a lot about the general pitch design process and the various variables that are relevant to that process. Today, we're going to begin to put all of that together as we go over the basics of pitch design for the fastball. But before we jump into this, welcome back to another video, guys. If you're new here and you're a coach, player, or trainer interested in learning more about the practical applications of data-driven baseball, you've come to the right place. Join the movement now by clicking the subscribe button down below for more weekly baseball animations. So first, we need to describe what the typical fastball is. And to begin with, we will base most of these numbers around the MLB average, since that's what we're all striving for, right? The average Major League fastball was thrown at 92.3 miles per hour in 2018. The average spin rate on this pitch was about 2,200 revolutions per minute. However, as we talked about in a previous video, the average spin rate increases as velocity increases. So to account for this, and how we use it at lower levels such as college and high school, is to determine the Bauer units for this pitch. On fastballs, at any velocity, the average Bauer units are about 24. Then lastly, this pitch is thrown in the zone about 45% of the time. This will be the highest of most pitchers' in zone percentage across all their pitches, and fastball command is something that is stressed constantly to pitchers at all levels. This information is all great, however, it doesn't give us the whole picture of how this athlete's fastball actually plays. What separates a good fastball from a bad one isn't always just velocity. There are other factors at play such as spin axis, spin efficiency, and the abnormality of this pitch. Most of these things actually can be altered through the pitch design process, and the one thing that I personally focus on is creating abnormalities. So now you may be asking, what can be done? When we begin to talk about pitch design, the two largest contributing factors to the movement of the pitch are going to be spin direction, or tilt of the pitch, and the horizontal and vertical break of that pitch, all of which are things that can be manipulated in some way. The single leading factor in movement profiles of fastballs is going to be that pitcher's arm slot. To oversimplify this idea, we will break down pitchers into four different arm slot categories: overhand, three-quarter, sidearm, and summary. When we talk about overhand throwers, guys like Clayton Kershaw come to mind. They're throwing directly over the top, and oftentimes this leads to a more straight fastball, meaning not a ton of horizontal break. And sometimes these guys may even cut their balls a little bit. Then there are three-quarter slot pitchers. This is one that you will stumble across the most often. These pitchers' fastballs live between the 1 o'clock and 2 o'clock mark for their tilt, and the fastball movement profile has similar horizontal and vertical break. Next are going to be sidearmers. These guys typically have a lot of horizontal movement and not a ton of vertical movement, potentially even sometimes negative vertical break on the fastball with a tilt between 230 and 330. And lastly are summerators, who throw anywhere from 330 to 430 tilt. Now this all may seem pretty straightforward, but it is important to understand when you begin to look at a pitcher's arsenal, like I said before, the goal with the fastball is to be different. And the guys who have stuff that hitters aren't used to are going to have more success than guys who see pitches that aren't. This isn't to say that your normal 130 tilt fastball needs to be eliminated, but if there is an opportunity to get an athlete out of this no-fly zone without hurting the rest of his stuff, work towards that. Now, what I am not saying is that every pitcher you've got has to change their arm slot. This is just another piece of the puzzle when you're beginning to create your MVP machine. The goal is to stack the deck with as many weapons as possible in your favor, so why not start with the pitch that most guys throw most often? Now that we've covered the typical fastball and its ideal movement profiles, let's jump you into the velocity and spin profiles. To begin with, yes, throwing your fastball harder on average is going to yield better results. But like we covered in the last slide, velocity isn't everything. There are several more factors to take into account here, such as that pitch's movement and spin efficiency. Typically in a full pitch design session, the majority of your time will be spent on breaking balls. However, this shouldn't be confused as not working on your fastball. Many times, coaches think pitch design and try to dive in and create the nastiest slider on the team and forget all about the fastball. You must remember that it is yet another tool to sharpen to widen the competitive advantage between pitchers and hitters. The fastball is the starting point. It paints the outline of what other pieces will fit into this pitcher's arsenal. When we talk about spin, it is never just going to be your spin rate. it must be relative to your guy's velocity. Like we said earlier, this comes from your Bauer units. I've done a video on these in the past, but your average Bauer units on fastball is going to be about 24. And your low and high numbers are going to fall about 1.5 units above and below that average. Like I said in that video, this rating doesn't identify good or bad pitches. It simply helps describe how each guy should be throwing in the zone. That is the same with the information covered in the last screen. Your movement profile for each guy is going to be unique, but what it can tell you is the proper secondary pitches to add to that pitcher's arsenal through this pitch design process. It's all based around the fastball. A fastball with a ton of horizontal break and not much vertical break should be paired with a slider to aid in the tunneling of that pitcher's arsenal. This guy should pitch east and west, or in and out of the zone, while a pitcher with high vertical break and low horizontal break should refine their curveball to mimic that same movement pattern, and this guy should work north and south, or up and down in the zone. All in all, every pitcher could use a tick or two to their average fastball velocity. But it is so much more than that. The usage of this pitch in the big leagues has steadily decreased over the years, to around about 40%, but it doesn't mean that it should be ignored when you get this guy on the bump in front of your Rep Soto. This pitch is yet another tool in each pitcher's arsenal that should be treated like the rest of the weapons stored in there, refined to their peak potential in order to achieve maximum results. Thanks for watching. If you liked today's video or you just want to support the channel, please leave a like down below. Leave a comment with any questions or suggestions for a future video, and subscribe for more weekly baseball animations posted every Wednesday.